Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to use the WordPress REST API, using it with Ajax in JavaScript, and making sure that we're getting dynamic content on the pages or in whatever location of WordPress we want to do that. Now we'll be doing that in a plugin, and we shall be able to see what I do, and maybe you can do something different or modify it and make your own application. Now, one of the things that uses the REST API in WordPress is the block editor. And you can see from here that there are different blocks that you can actually pick. You can do different things with them, you can edit them, and this is a little bit complex in terms of nature. So actually, the new editor uses things like React, JavaScript, the REST API, and so many other things that are wrapped around each other to have these complex kinds of workings in it. So what we are going to do is we're going to use what we call a shortcode. So I'm going to come to this page here, and what I'll do is I'll look for a shortcode block. And we're going to say we're going to have a shortcode which we're going to call REST-Ajax. On saving this and publishing, we should be able to go and view this page on our website, and you'll see that we have this REST-Ajax as a shortcode, but it does nothing. So let me copy this right here. I'm going to go to my editor. I'll go in the plugins section of my site. So basically, I've just dragged and dropped my public folder in my editor, and I'm going to open a new folder here, which I'll call this REST Ajax. And in here, I'll open a new file, which I'll call REST-Ajax.php, and that will allow us to start our plugin. So I'm going to write some PHP here, and I'll write the expected comments from WordPress to start our plugin. I'm using a code snippet from my editor, and it allows me to do this. So I'm going to have this as REST Ajax working together. And then I'll change these other things, and I'm going to fast forward this video just to make sure that we finish writing this plugin. So after starting up our plugin, I'm going to do some basic security in here, and we're going to look for the apps path. So when WordPress plugins run normally, they usually define the apps path, and then if that's not defined, that means we're not running the plugin normally. So we should say unauthorized access. And the first thing that I'll come to do, I'm going to first close my integrated terminal right here. I'm going to come here, and then I'm going to write the shortcode. So I'll say shortcode for REST Ajax. So the first thing we do is use the action hook of add shortcode, and inside here it expects a tag and a callback function. So the tag that we're going to have is going to be similar to what we put in our shortcode on the front end. So we put REST Ajax in the brackets here, and then we're going to write a function which I'll just call takepress REST Ajax. So takepress underscore REST Ajax shortcode. And that will allow me to have a unique function. So I'll put it here and then write the word function before it, and then put our brackets that are necessary to write our function. And the first thing I want to do here is say I'm going to echo. And what I want to echo here is say initial shortcode text. And that's what we're going to have. I'll add a semicolon at the end to make sure we don't have any failures. And I'm going to come back in my admin area. I'll go to the plugin section. And in the plugins, I'll activate our REST Ajax that's working together. And if I come back and reload this page, you're going to see that we have this initial shortcode text. Now we have this running outside here because it doesn't have any particular HTML to it. So when I highlight this and go and preview it, you'll see it just has this. Yet all these other pieces have paragraphs and so on. So let me wrap this in a paragraph, and then I'll close it off. Save this, let's go and preview our text again. And you'll see we have this properly indented and it's in the right place. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to create a REST API endpoint. And that endpoint is going to provide us all the information that we need to throw right here on our page. So I'll come back here and I'm going to use an action. So I'll say add action. So in here, we'll use the hook that says REST API init. So when the REST API is initialized, we should have a function in here that should run at that point. And I'm just going to copy this right here and say techiepress REST AJAX, and I'll say endpoint. Now with this, I'm going to write a new function and give it that name, and of course add our brackets. And here I'll just scroll this up so that we have more estate. And in here we're going to use the register REST route. And that's the function that we have here, and it expects to have a namespace, it expects to have a route, and any other arguments that you might pass in here. The first thing, we'll have our namespace. The namespace I'm going to call techiepress, and then after our namespace, I'm going to add a route which I'll call REST AJAX. I'll add a comma here, and right here we're going to have our arguments, which is an array of stuff. And the first thing we're going to do is register the method that we're going to use on the REST API. And we're basically going to use a get because we want to get information. If we wanted to send information to that endpoint, we would use the post method. We now need to write the permissions and say permission callback should actually be mapped to return true. So we have two double underscores, then we have return underscore true, and we'll add a comma at the end. And then after that, we're going to have our callback function. Just remove the extra B, and then of course here we can put pass in our callback that we want to have, and I'll just copy this techiepress REST AJAX, and I'm going to add the word callback at the end just to make it stand out. I'll copy this, and then we can have that function here, of course, with the brackets being opened up. And I just need to add a semicolon right here, and I'll move this into space so that it matches the alignment with all the other methods. Now, of course, this does not add any particular thing to your code because PHP ignores the spaces, but it allows you to make your code a little more readable. Now, I'm going to save this, and then we're going to go to the techiepress endpoint, and we're going to look at the REST AJAX endpoint. Now, the way we see that on our WordPress site is we get our URL, which is this. I'm going to put it here. I'll type wp-json, and then at the end we're going to have the techiepress namespace, and we're going to look for the REST-AJAX here. And when I hit enter, you'll see that we have some errors on line 35, which we need to fix. So line 35 has this, but we did not close with our semicolon at this point. So I need to fix that with this method. Then if I come back and reload, you'll see that we don't have anything on this point. And it says nothing was found, so that means there's an error in our code. If I come back and look at the namespace, it's right. We have the right endpoint. Method is supposed to be methods right here. Permission callback is correct, it's returning true, and the callback should be a double L. And once we have this double L and our name here working properly, if we save this and come back and reload here, you'll now see that this is showing and we don't have anything in here. So what I'm going to do is come back to our code here, and I'm going to echo a simple word, and I'll say techiepress was here. And instead of echoing, I am just going to return this and save this, and that will mean this callback is going to return one thing. If I come back here and reload, you'll see that we have techiepress showing up here, and that's the correct endpoint. So we are going to be calling this REST endpoint, and we're going to call that data to show up actually right here. So I'll come back to my code in here, and I'm going to do some stuff with AJAX. But before that, let me just comment out this URL and also comment our code. So we'll have create a short code for the REST AJAX endpoint. Then we shall create a new endpoint, create new endpoint to provide data. These comments are really good if you want to make sure that your code is readable in the near future. And then after doing that, this is a callback, so this is the REST endpoint information. And now we're going to start writing our AJAX. So here we'll say write AJAX to show the information in the short code. So the one thing that we are going to do is, instead of actually making a new function and a new hook, I'm going to just cut all of this, and then I'm going to bring it here in our short code, and we shall have this only running when this short code has been added. And what we're going to do here is we're going to use two WordPress methods. One is the WP enqueue, and we're going to enqueue the script. That's what we're going to do at this point. So this method will actually allow us to enqueue our JavaScript and have a JavaScript file here. So the one thing that we need in here is a handle, and we'll say this is the REST AJAX, and we'll say JavaScript or script. And after adding a handle, which is more like an ID, we need to add the source of our JavaScript. So I'll say plugin, and we're going to look for the plugin's URL, which is a default WordPress function. And in here, we're going to pass in a path. So we shall create a new directory called assets, and in here we'll have JavaScript, and we're going to have our script in here.js. So that's what I need to create here. In this plugin, I'll create a new folder called assets. In assets, I'll create a new folder called JS. And inside that, I'm going to create a new file, which I'll call script.js. And we shall write all our JavaScript here. Now, after doing this, I'm going to get this URL that we have here, cut it, save this. And I'm going to come back to this location and just paste that comment right here. Now, if we are going to use AJAX, we'll actually need to be tapping inside an event, because that's the way JavaScript works. It works with events. And that means we need to go back to this code, and we should give this an ID. And so the only way we shall identify that HTML is if we actually have something here to identify it. And we're going to say that is the techie press text. That will be our ID right here. And then what I'm going to do here, instead of echoing this, I'm going to escape PHP and then just have my HTML, and then I'll open up PHP right again here. I'll tap that and I'll save this. If I come back to our front end and reload, nothing is going to change, but we shall be able to have this paragraph with that ID. So I'll come back to our JavaScript, because that's where we're going to focus most of the time. But before I go there, I need to make sure that this code that I've enqueued, I actually add some dependencies to it. So in here, we're going to use jQuery. And remember, jQuery comes by default in WordPress. So we'll use jQuery because we want to use AJAX that comes from jQuery as a package. And we're going to say, let this have a version of 0.1.0, because that's the same as our initial plugin. We can always update that whenever we have a new version of our script or a new version of our plugin. And I'll say here, let this be true, because we want to load this script in the footer of our web page. And that is simply because that will allow our pages to load faster, and it will allow us to tap into the JavaScript when the whole DOM has been loaded. So after doing that, I'm going to come back in here, and we'll know we'll be getting this techypress.txt, which is going to be an ID that we'll use. I'll comment it out for a later use, and I'm going to start writing some jQuery. So I'll say, let's have our jQuery. In our jQuery, the first thing we'll do is say, let's find out if the document is actually ready. So if the document is ready, then we shall perform the particular code that's going to be in here. Now inside this, we shall have a function, and in this function, we're going to assign the dollar sign so that it takes this jQuery and represents it. So in the function, we're going to come down here and we shall say our jQuery right now. We're going to do some Ajax calls. That's what we shall say. Of course, terminate this. And inside this Ajax, we're going to use some curly brackets. And in these curly brackets, we are going to pass in the URL. Now the URL that we need is actually this statement right here. But I'm not going to quote the beginning part of our domain. I'm just going to get the wp.json from here, copy it, and then I'm going to pass it inside strings because we don't want to have any issues with our JavaScript. Now, this basically tells Ajax, go to this URL that you see here, and then you're going to get some information. So after this has been done, and this is a method in jQuery, what we want to do at that point is we want to console.log whatever information we've got from that endpoint, and we want to just have it here. So I'm going to console log the data right here. So I'll save this. Let's come back to our particular URL. I'm going to reload this, and I'll open up the console, and you will see that there's a bit of some issues that we have. And the reason is our plugin is actually not passing in the right URL for the JavaScript. So I'll come back here and I'm going to go to the plugin's URL. This function actually requires two arguments. So I'll add a comma here and I'm going to add this file to say, hey, plugin's URL function, do you want to get the file? Make sure the plugin that you're working with is the one that this file, this very file that we're working in, is. After getting that plugin folder, then you can attach these different pieces of information to it. So I'll save this, come back here, and I'll reload. And you'll see that we have some issues now in our jQuery, which is good. So we see that this is going to the sample page, and then it's going to the wp.json. And that's not what we expect. So I'm going to come back to our script right here, and I'm going to put a slash to basically say on the default URL, then go to the wp.json, then techypress, then REST Ajax. I'll come back, reload this, and you'll see that it's telling us data is not actually defined. So what I'm going to do, instead of just console logging this data, I'm going to write a function here, and then I'll pass in the data first and foremost, then we can actually be able to use this data. So I'll push this console log in here to log the data, and then I'll reduce this spacing just to make this look right. I'll save this, come back here and reload, and you'll see that we get the techypress was actually here. That's the information on our endpoint. So we are using the REST API and Ajax to get our information in real time. Now you might be asking yourself, why do you keep on making bugs and making errors? Because that's the way coding is. You try different things, you mess up. Even when you remember particular things, coders are not superhuman, and definitely I'm not one. But I also allow these errors to occur so that when you get to that place where you're also having those errors, you can be able to troubleshoot and know how to fix some of those errors. So now that we have our data showing up here, we're going to be able to actually push it back to our HTML right here. So in here, instead of console logging the data, I'm going to just come here and say we're going to use Ajax, and Ajax is going to find for us something. It is going to find for us the ID that has this TechiePress text. So I'll put in here, I'll add our pound sign to basically say find the ID that has TechiePress text. Then you're going to say the text of that is actually going to equal to the data that we have here. So I'll copy this and put in the data right here. I'll come back here and I'll reload, and you'll see that our text actually changes coming from the REST API, and it replaces the original text that we had here. So that's how you can actually use the REST API and AJAX to have good content. I'm going to use the JSON tpcode API, and this is basically a fake JSON API, and I'll just go to it, and we're going to use some of the URLs that are actually open for us to do so. For example, when you run the to-dos here, you'll see that you actually get back this one to-do right here. If you want to run so many, you'll have these other resources available, so you can be able to get posts, albums, photos, to-dos, users, and so on. So for now, I'm actually going to just go and get some posts, and we shall get all these posts that are coming from here, and we shall throw them inside our particular page. So the first thing that I'll do is edit this page, because I don't want us to have all the other information that comes after. We're just only going to leave our shortcode. So I'll remove this block, and then I'll update this. And after updating this, we should be able to go and view our URL, and you'll see we just have TechiePress was here. So we're going to do a little bit of stuff in here. I want to try out something with you. Let's just go and call this API and then just get back that data and throw it on our endpoint here. And the way we do that is we're going to come back to our PHP right here. And inside this PHP, in our callback function, we're going to have something called data. And this data on the onset is going to just equal to something that's empty. And we're going to use the WP remote get function, which is the way we ping particular APIs. Now, when we use the remote get, we want to get information. When we use the remote post, we want to send information to a URL. You can also use the WP remote request, which allows you to use either the get method or the post method. But for now, we're just going to use the get method in here. And we're going to pass in the URL. So I'm going to pass in this URL like this. And after passing in the URL, I can pass in some other arguments that I need to have. So let's say we have args here. I'll describe our args up right here. I'll say args is actually going to equal to an array of data. And inside here, we're just going to say, let's pass the methods. And the method is actually going to be the get method. We need to wrap this in some strings and then add a comma. We'll save this. And what we're going to do is say, let's get our response right here. After getting our response, we'll say it's equal to that. And then we are going to return the response instead of this text. So I'll copy and paste this right here. But I need a semicolon here so that my editor stops screaming at me. Then I'll save this and say we're returning the response. If I come back here and reload this, you'll see that it's going to throw an object right here. That means it's getting a lot of information from this endpoint, which is basically the user, the ID, the title, the body, and that's coming back as an object. So I'll open up our scripts again, because that's where we're getting the data, and then I just want to console log that data. I'll add a semicolon here, so that we can see it when we come here. So I'll reload this. We see we have our object there. I'll inspect this, go to our console, and you're going to see that we have our headers and we have a body in here. So the way we retrieve the body and the header in our PHP is this way. So we can go and say our response is actually going to equal to the WP remote retrieve. And we want to retrieve the body at this point. And the body we want to retrieve is what we get from the response here. So I'll paste that in, add a semicolon, save this. Let's come back here, see what we get. And you'll see that now we are getting this data coming back right here. And you'll see that we actually have a JSON script in here. We have JSON being returned right here. So what we need to do in the first case is we need to actually decode what we get here. So I'll say our response is going to equal to JSON-decode. And that's basically saying we want to get our JSON that we get from the response, and we want to decode it so that we can use it in the ordinary PHP way. So I'll remove all those spaces in there, and then I'm going to come back here, I'll reload this page. You'll see now we're getting different objects coming back. So we have an array of objects. So we can actually loop through each one of those objects if we need to. So after getting our array with all these objects here, we can actually tap off the ID, the user ID, and the title if we need to. So the way we'd do that is we shall go through the array, and for the first array, I'm just going to get the first array. And after getting the first array, I just want to get the title from that particular object. So let's go and check our console log. I'll reload this page, and you'll see that we get only this item showing up here. And we can actually pass that information inside this location right here. Let's move on. I'm going to comment this out right here, and I'm going to use a for each statement. So for each of our data items, we're going to have a block that is returned. And for each one of those blocks, we are just going to say, let's have a paragraph. So I'll open some quotations here. And I'm going to say, let's have a paragraph. And inside that paragraph, of course, we need to close it. We're going to open up our JavaScript, and we shall use the plus symbols to say we are appending some JavaScript work. And we shall say for the block, let's go and get the title of the block. So since we are inside this loop, we're going to take advantage of what we already have here. So I'm going to say on this techiepress.txt, I want us to append, and what we want to append is a paragraph with a block title over there, and we're going to add a semicolon at the end right here, and then I'll remove this extra stuff we don't need. So I'm going to save this. Let's come back here, I'll reload this page, and you're going to see that we have our initial shortcode text, then we have paragraphs and titles that are following here after. So we can do more stuff if we need to this, so I'm going to inspect this. You'll see that this paragraph actually has nothing to it. So I'm going to come back here, and I'm going to use what we have right in here. I'll copy it, I'm going to paste it in here, and I'm going to change the title to our ID. We just wanted to have an ID, so I'll say ID is equal to this, and then I'm going to add another quotation right here, save this, so that we can actually have the right stuff. So we now have the proper text showing up here with an ID of 1, ID of 2, ID of 3, right here, ID of 4, and so on. So you can do so much more with the REST API. You can also use it to ping and call actual data. Then you can use your AJAX to have all that content in real time. So if you actually have seen this and this is something you wanted to use, you can actually attach a button to make that call so that you're not just calling the AJAX right here. You're triggering it on a button. That's how you can do this. You can have your REST API bringing in all the data, doing all the PHP stuff for you, and then sending that down to your JavaScript, and then adding it inside your particular HTML, and you can have WordPress doing amazing things for you. Now, you might ask me, why didn't you do everything inside AJAX itself? Why did you have to use an endpoint to have PHP running the rest of your calls right here? And I would say the reason why we use the REST API, first and foremost, it is secure. You're not having issues that come from Ajax and so on, adding privileges and also non-privileges and so on. The REST API, you've instructed it to have the stuff that needs to be done. You've given it the permissions that need to be given. Everything is straight out of the box and ready for you. There is a security layer that has been added to your application. So I would advise you from now on, instead of using the pure Ajax to do all that, use a REST endpoint, work like the way Gutenberg is working, and then you can use your JavaScript to just add some of those interactive nature kind of things like the button clicks, like the spinning and waiting for the data to come in, and then you put your code as HTML on your front end or even in your back end. So if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and leave me a comment or a question down below. Make sure you've tried this, try to optimize it to your own use case. Then we can have a conversation about it. Otherwise, enjoy whatever you're developing and don't stop.